Pokemon Unite. Too much grind, not enough content. Pokemon Unite is a 5v5 arena battle game where you play as your selected Pokemon, throw on items to boost their stats, and you'll be thrown into an arena. Here there will be wild Pokemon that you gain points from defeating, and you have to get to your opponent's zone and score. You have to bank your points because the rival team can defeat you and take your points. On paper, this seems kind of boring. You'll get bored of this quickly. What makes it not so boring? Well, as you battle, you level up. You'll always start with the basic form of your Pokemon, but as you battle, your Pokemon will again level up, unlocking new moves. In each game, you can try different moves out as you get to choose one of two moves to learn. And some Pokemon will even evolve. Sadly, Pikachu doesn't, but most do. So you'll become more powerful as the match goes on, really creating an addictive loop. Try new Pokemon, try new evolve paths. And randomly, other wild Pokemon will show up, and by your team defeating them together, you can really change the tide of the battle. Now here comes my issue with Pokemon Unite. The grind is just unacceptable. In Pokemon Unite, there are 20 characters total for now to unlock. I say for now because War Turtle shows up in the tutorial, but Blastoise is not a playable character, so clearly more will come. But back to the rant. From the start, after you finish the tutorials, you get to choose one character, and you'll unlock Slowbro as well. Continue playing through the advanced tutorials and win a game, you'll have enough to buy a cheap Pokemon like a Pikachu or Snorlax. You now have 3 Pokemon. You'll easily unlock Venusaur from leveling up. 4. For the first $20 you invest, you'll be able to get 4 out of the 5 most expensive Pokemon. 3 from daily login, including the final 5th of the most expensive. That's 11 Pokemon, and you'll only have 9 more to unlock for only spending $20. You'll have to grind for the remaining 9 to 13 if you don't want to put money into this game. Though it seems every week you'll be able to complete challenges to unlock a new character as well. So everything goes well, you didn't spend any money by the end of the game's first 2 weeks, you'll have 9 Pokemon out of 20 free to use. How long will it take to get the final 11 without money? I'm sorry you asked. You get about 40 coins for a win, 20 for a loss. Let's say on average 30 coins per match, 13 minutes per battle with low times, 150 coins per hour. You'll need around 82,000 coins, 42,000 if you throw $20 in. That only takes about, 547 hours, or 273 hours if you throw in $20. Meaning that basically, for the most expensive Pokemon like Gengar, you have to play this game for 67 hours to unlock just him. That's insanely ridiculous. Obviously with daily challenges, you get bonus coins here and there, but still. There's no game that should take more than 4 to 6 hours to unlock a new character. The only way I'm okay with this is let's say every week it's a new Pokemon to unlock on the 7th day. No strings attached, no duplicates, it's on a cycle. Sure, I'll play for one day a week for the next 3 months. That's not too crazy to ask. But if this is just introductory, this is completely predatory. And I honestly don't see this happening. I see maybe just a mid-tier Pokemon on loop. There's no way you'll ever see Gengar chilling there ready for you to earn. You either have to buy him, play for 67 hours, or about 10 hours if you save all your intro coins and ignore the likes of Pikachu or Charizard. That is crazy to me. Let's say you don't want to grind. I want to treat this like a full price game. I'll pay for everything and I'll have all the characters to play with so I don't get bored. How much will that cost me? Only the low price of $99.99 USD. And that's if you include the hopefully 5 free characters you get in the first 2 weeks. If not, $100 doesn't even get you every character, let alone the cosmetics you may want. There's not enough here content wise to justify the pricing. There's only one map, and I'm already bored of it. Pokemon Unite is a great game with great potential, it really is. I love it, I love actually playing the game. But the grind is just unacceptable and needs to be rebalanced. Otherwise you're gonna get bored after one day, and there's no new Pokemon for you to play with to string you along to keep you going. I give Pokemon Unite a 7.5 out of 10. If you play Pokemon Unite, tell me what you thought about it down in the comment section below. If you haven't played it, tell me if you plan on picking it up. Thumbs up. If you'd like the video, subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram at SuperKenGaming. Thanks for watching, of course. Stay beautiful.
'Thought that video was good, ha! You should probably watch this video, the very video that's on your screen right now that YouTube hand selected for you. Out of all my thousands of videos, this is the one that it wants you to watch next. And make sure you're subscribed, because I'm not a genie or anything, but I'm pretty sure you get 42 years of bad luck if you made it this far into my video and you're not subscribed. You don't have to subscribe, but I'm just looking out for you. I'm just looking out for your luck and your life.